Forget winter. Summer is coming. And along with it comes wolves driving cars that look like sheep, going over the speed limit until they are rolling up beside me, uninvited guests crashing a party that I thought was just going to be me taking a walk and getting some coffee. Black absorbs heat, but it's still the only color I wear when it's hot. I'll keep my red hair tucked in a baseball cap because at least then I can convince myself that they did not confuse me for a stop sign. Can convince myself that I didn't ask for this. Warm weather comes with a certain set of guidelines, almost illegible, because the pairs of paws that print these rules have trouble seeing where the line is. Dress classy, but not trashy. Dressed like the men at the police station wouldn't have a problem with what you were wearing. Be smart and pretty, or just pretty. Covered up but not a prude, sultry but not a slut, be skinny but not skeletal, curvy but in all the right places. And don't worry, they'll tell you what those are. Scream them out a window. Nice tits, that's a fat ass. Be confident but don't be a bitch. Act like one of the guys, but don't be butch, can be his friend. But can't say no, men who catcall mistake collarbones for wishbones. They will leave you to drive and break you in half. Drive-bys with pickup lines that wouldn't have gotten them the girl even if he wasn't going 50 kilometers an hour in the opposite direction of her. I once had two men pull over beside me and ask me to walk back across the street in front of them, put on a little show for them, turned a chewed gum and cigarette butt road into a runway for me, hoped I lacked the self-confidence to become a model for them because they did not look at me like woman. They looked at me like object, like woman came from man, like you can't even spell woman without man, like he doesn't have to ask me or touch me to feel like a part of me already belongs to him. But what he forgot was that Eve, coming from Adam's rib, was man's only way to give the illusion that he is capable of fostering life. When I can find something with a better genetic makeup than him and his friend's angel falling from heaven bullshit in a violet Planned Parenthood. I don't understand how you can treat vagina, or should I say pussy, as commodity when I'm sure your mother taught you where you came from. When a man catcalls me, the last thing I'm thinking is, what is his phone number? Because I'm too busy making sure my house key is jutting out between my middle and pointer finger because I don't feel as safe not wearing rings when I go out. When a man yells that I look like a rag doll, I stand like I have a metal rod in my back, give the illusion that my spine will not fit in a glass cabinet, that he cannot lock up my consent and my backbone like the good liquor. But when he pulls over beside me, the sharp side of a key will not stop him from taking a hammer to my vertebrae, gluing them back together, and putting them on display. This poem is for all the men who hang their heads out of car windows like they're reverse guillotines. I will not be entertained by your execution, but I will smile when your decapitated masculinity rolls to my feet before it gets the chance to tell me I look prettier that way.